हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ मशीन डिजाइन। नाउ इन द पास्ट फ्यू लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर, हाउ टू डिजाइन अ मशीन एलिमेंट सब्जेक्टेड टू स्टैटिक लोडिंग। फॉर दैट वी यूज थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर। वी सॉ फाइव थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर। इन दिस लेक्चर माई फ्रेंड, वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ फेलियर इन ऑर्डर टू डिजाइन द मशीन एलिमेंट। सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी द एप्लीकेशन पार्ट of theories of failure in today's lecture, my friend. So be there till the end of this video. Now, if you're watching me for the first time, let me give a brief description, a brief introduction. My name is Apurup Rao. I did my M.Tech from IIT Kharagpur and my specialization was mechanical systems design. Then I worked for 2 years in Mahindra Research Valley, which is the research and development center of Mahindra and Mahindra cars and tractors. Basically, the cars and tractors of Mahindra and Mahindra are designed there. So I was there for 2 years and my job basically was to design and analyze the body parts of cars. Mahindra XUV 500, KUV, TUV, all these vehicles were designed there. So I worked there for 2 years. And then I quit my job and I started teaching. I always had a passion for teaching. So I started teaching. I've been teaching for more than 6 years now. I've taught thousands of students preparing for GATE and engineering services. And here on our YouTube channel, I've been teaching you the subjects of design. I've recently completed the entire syllabus of Strength of Material. You can go and watch the playlist of Strength of Material. You will find 27 lectures, my friend. 27 lectures of Strength of Material. In the same way, I am going to complete the entire syllabus of machine design in this lecture series, my friend. Okay. So if you have not subscribed our channel, go and subscribe the channel to get these amazing online lectures live, completely free of cost, my friend. So please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so that you will be notified whenever I am live with my lecture, my friend. Okay. And my friend, don't forget to hit the like button. It is like an online attendance. It is like a virtual attendance. So if you are present in my class, hit the like button and mark your presence, my friend. And we need your support in order to grow our channel. In order to grow, we need your support, my friend. See, we are making a lot of efforts making these online lectures for you. So please support us in this journey by sharing our videos with all your friends, my friend. Please tell them that there are amazing online lectures right now on this YouTube channel. We have the online lectures of different subjects, my friend. Thermodynamics, fluid mechanics, manufacturing science, production engineering, theories of machine, strength of material, machine design, all the subjects are taken care of. So please tell your friends to subscribe this channel and watch these videos. The schedule is very simple, my friend. Since morning, we start our classes from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. There are classes in Hindi medium. Then in the evening, from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m., there are classes in English medium. And from 9 p.m. to 11 p.m., there is a special batch for SSC, JEE, PSU and other state level exams. So we have divided all these lectures into different schedules, my friend. You'll find the schedule in one of the videos, my friend. So please go through the schedule and don't miss any lecture, my friend. Don't miss any lecture. Okay. Now we have a few more offerings for you. In the description of this video, you will find the link of our Telegram channel. If you follow that channel, we will give you all the study material, all the relevant study material, PDF, notes, everything on that channel only. Okay. So if you want the notes regarding to this lecture, then you have to follow the Telegram channel right now. In the description of the video, there is the link. So go and follow that Telegram channel. And also in the link of the video, you will find in the description of the video, you will find the link of our Facebook group. So please be a member of that Facebook group. In that Facebook group, we are going to discuss about our strategies. We are going to discuss about problems. So be a part of that Facebook group. So this is all we are offering, my friends. Okay. Now, my friends, today's lecture is regarding the implementation, the application of theories of failure. So let's see how A machine element is designed when it is subjected to static loading. Okay, so I will take a very important example. I will take an example of a circular shaft, my friend. Okay, we will design a circular shaft subjected to static loading, my friend. Okay, so let's discuss this problem, my friends. Let's discuss this problem. Okay, hit the like button and mark your presence first. Okay, hit the like button and mark your presence, and then focus on this problem, my friend. This problem is related to design of shaft. Okay, so mark this problem, write down this problem. We have a solid circular shaft. We have a solid circular shaft subjected to bending moment of 5 kilonewton meter, bending moment of 5 kilonewton meter, and a torque of 8 kilonewton meter. Okay, so we have a circular shaft which is subjected to bending moment as well as twisting moment. It is combined bending and twisting. Yield strength of material is given. Yield strength of the material is 350 megapascal, and factor of safety is 2. Okay, now what do we need to find, my friend? Find a safe diameter of the shaft using first Guest theory, and second, von Mises theory. What do we need to use? We need to use guest theory and we need to use von Mises theory. So we have two different theories of failure, and we have to design the shaft. By designing the shaft, what do I mean? Designing the shaft means finding the diameter, safe diameter of the shaft. Okay, if the diameter is less than the safe value, then it will fail. So we have to save the shaft. We have to find a safe diameter of the shaft using two different theories of failure. First, we have to use guess theory, and second, we have to use von Mises theory. So this is a problem related to design of shaft, my friend. A very important concept, a very important problem. So note this problem down, and then we will start with the solution. Note this problem. You have to note down these values, my friend. Bending moment is 5 kilonewton meter, torque is 8 kilonewton meter, SYT is 350, factor of safety is 2. Okay, so note these values, and we have to find safe diameter using these two theories of failure, guess theory and von Mises theory. Okay, so let's use these two theories of failure and let's find out the diameter of the shaft, my friend. Okay, note this problem. We will solve this problem together. We will solve the first problem related to design. This is the first problem related to design, my friend. In this journey of machine design, we will design a lot of machine elements. This is the first machine element which we are going to design. Okay, we are going to design the shaft now. Okay, so let's design this shaft together. So what's the problem, my friend? What is the problem? Let's discuss the problem using this diagram. So we have a circular shaft. Okay, we have a circular shaft which is subjected to two different loads. It is subjected to a bending moment like this. What is the bending moment, my friend? 5 kilonewton meter. And it is also subjected to a torque like this. What is the torque, my friend? It is 8 kilonewton meter. And what do we need to find? We need to find the diameter, my friend. Yield strength, we know. We know the yield strength of the material. We know the yield strength. It is 350 megapascal. And we know the factor of safety. It is 2. Now, my friend, we need to calculate the safe diameter of the shaft using theories of failure. So, in any problem related to theories of failure, द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज टू फाइंड प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस. ओके, वी नीड टू फर्स्ट फाइंड प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस. ओके, वी नीड टू फाइंड प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस. नाउ माई फ्रेंड, वी हैव अ डायरेक्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस फॉर कंबाइंड बेंडिंग एंड ट्विस्टिंग. वी हैव डिराइव्ड दिस इक्वेशन इन द चैप्टर ऑफ कंबाइंड लोडिंग. इफ यू हैव नॉट वॉच्ड माई वीडियोज ऑन स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटीरियल, डोंट वरी, नो प्रॉब्लम माई फ्रेंड. आफ्टर द लेक्चर एंड्स आई वुड रिकमेंड दैट यू गो एंड वॉच द वीडियोज ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटीरियल, स्पेशली द वीडियो ऑन प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस एंड द वीडियो ऑन कंबाइंड लोडिंग. ओके, इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड मशीन डिजाइन यू नीड दीज टू कॉन्सेप्ट. सो प्लीज वॉच द वीडियो ऑन प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस एंड कंबाइंड लोडिंग. ओके, आफ्टर दिस लेक्चर एंड्स, नो प्रॉब्लम. इफ यू हैव नॉट वॉच्ड, आई विल एक्सप्लेन, आई विल रिवाइज द कॉन्सेप्ट. ऑल राइट, सो प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस सिग्मा वन एंड सिग्मा टू इन केस ऑफ कंबाइंड बेंडिंग एंड ट्विस्टिंग. वॉट इज द फॉर्मूला माई फ्रेंड, वॉट इज द फॉर्मूला? दिस इज द फॉर्मूला, 16 बाय पाई डी क्यू एम प्लस माइनस रूट ओवर एम स्क्वायर प्लस टी स्क्वायर. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला. नोट दिस फॉर्मूला डाउन, मेमोराइज दिस फॉर्मूला, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूला. ओके, सिग्मा वन एंड सिग्मा टू कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड डायरेक्टली इन केस ऑफ कंबाइंड बेंडिंग एंड ट्विस्टिंग. देयर इज नो अदर लोड, ओनली बेंडिंग मोमेंट एंड ट्विस्टिंग मोमेंट. ओके, सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला माई फ्रेंड. एम इज द बेंडिंग मोमेंट, टी इज द ट्विस्टिंग मोमेंट, डी इज द डायामीटर ऑफ शाफ्ट. नाउ रिमेंबर माई फ्रेंड, वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग द डायामीटर, वी आर फाइंडिंग द डायमेंशन. सो इन द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ डिजाइन, वेन यू विल कैलकुलेट द प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस, यू विल नॉट गेट अ वैल्यू, यू विल गेट अ फंक्शन इन टर्म्स ऑफ डायमेंशन ऑफ द बॉडी. When we will calculate principal stress, we will get the principal stress in terms of diameter, because right now the diameter is unknown. Right now the diameter is unknown. So when we will calculate principal stress, we will get some value in terms of diameter. And when we will put these values in the equation of theories of failure, then finally we will get the diameter. So do you understand the process of design? This is how machine elements are designed, my friend. What we will do? We will first calculate principal stresses in terms of dimension. Here, what is the dimension? Diameter. So, we will calculate principal stresses in terms of diameter. We will get some value in terms of diameter. And then we will put principal stresses in the equation of theories of failure. We have five equations of five theories of failure. In every equation, you have some relation with principal stresses and strength of material. You have some relation between principal stresses and strength. So when we will put the values in principal stresses, and then we will get the dimension. Okay, so look at the process, look at the process, understand the process. Okay, so right now I am calculating principal stresses in terms of diameter. Okay, so put the values here, put the values here. Diameter is unknown. Okay, what is bending moment? 5 kilo Newton meter. Convert it into Newton mm. What you will get? When you will convert it in Newton mm, you will get 5 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm. Okay, this will also become 8 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm. So 10 to the power 6 is common. Let's take that common. Okay, let's take that common. It will become into 10 to the power 6. Okay, now put the value of bending moment, 5 plus 5 square plus twisting moment is 8. Okay, so this is the equation of principal stress. If you will use plus, you will get sigma 1. If you use minus, you will get sigma 2. So solve this equation and tell me what is the value of sigma 1. Tell me what is the value of sigma 1. Solve this equation, my friend. Solve this equation. You will get some value in terms of diameter. So solve this equation in your calculator and tell me what is the diameter, what is sigma 1, my friend. Solve this equation and tell me what is sigma 1. Put the values in calculator and solve the equation, my friend. Solve the equation and tell me what you are getting. Tell me what you are getting. So you must be getting दिस वैल्यू माय फ्रेंड सिग्मा वन विल बी इक्वल टू, सिग्मा वन विल बी इक्वल टू 73.51 इंटू 10^6 डिवाइडेड बाय डी क्यू. दिस इज द फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ डायामीटर. डायामीटर इज अननोन राइट नाउ. एंड सिग्मा टू इट विल बी नेगेटिव माय फ्रेंड, इट विल बी नेगेटिव माइनस 22.58 इंटू 10^6 डी क्यू. दीज आर प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस माय फ्रेंड. व्हाट विल बी द थर्ड प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस, व्हाट विल बी द थर्ड प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस, इट विल बी जीरो. व्हाई इट विल बी जीरो, बिकॉज इट इज बाय एक्सियल स्ट्रेस. ओके, इट इज बाय एक्सियल स्ट्रेस. इन बाय एक्सियल स्ट्रेस द थर्ड प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस इज ऑलवेज जीरो. वी विल ओनली गेट टू प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस, सिग्मा वन एंड सिग्मा टू. सो नोट दिस डाउन, दीज आर योर प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस. दिस इज फर्स्ट स्टेप, दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप फाइंडिंग प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस. ओके, अनलेस यू हैव प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस यू कांट यूज थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर. इन ऑर्डर टू यूज थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर यू नीड प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस. ओके, नाउ व्हाट थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर यू नीड, यू हैव टू थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर. इन द क्वेश्चन इट इज मेंशनड यू हैव टू यूज टू डिफरेंट थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर. व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट थ्योरी ऑफ फेलियर माय फ्रेंड, गेस्ट थ्योरी. गेस्ट थ्योरी. नाउ व्हाट इज गेस्ट थ्योरी माय फ्रेंड, आई टोल्ड यू यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ फेलियर. सो व्हाट इज गेस्ट थ्योरी, इट इज नथिंग बट मैक्सिमम शियर स्ट्रेस थ्योरी. रिमेंबर गेस्ट थ्योरी इज मैक्सिमम शियर स्ट्रेस थ्योरी, द सेकेंड थ्योरी वी सॉ, मैक्सिमम शियर स्ट्रेस थ्योरी. नाउ माय फ्रेंड व्हाट इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ मैक्सिमम शियर स्ट्रेस, टाउ मैक्सिमम इक्वल टू एसवाईटी बाय 2FOS. दिस इज द मैक्सिमम शियर स्ट्रेस थ्योरी. टाउ मैक्सिमम शुड बी इक्वल टू एसवाईटी बाय 2FOS. नाउ विच वन विल बी टाउ मैक्सिमम माय फ्रेंड, विच वन विल बी टाउ मैक्सिमम. रिमेंबर आई टोल्ड यू वेन एवर यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट टाउ मैक्सिमम, व्हाट डिड आई टेल यू, what did I tell you, always do this my friend, always do this. You have to see which circle will be the biggest. So first principal stress is positive, first principal stress is positive, it will be somewhere here. Second principal stress, look at this, it is negative. Look at the second principal stress, it is negative. So it will be somewhere here my friend. Second principal stress will be negative, minus sigma. Okay, and third principal stress is zero my friend. Third principal stress will be here. Now my friend, you have three circle, 1, 3, 2, 3 and 1, 2. Which one is the biggest circle? This one is the biggest circle, 1, 2. And what will be the diameter my friend? Sigma 1 minus sigma 2. So what will be the radius? What will be the radius? This will be your tau maximum. So what will be the radius? Sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2. Okay. Tau maximum is maximum of sigma 1 minus 2 by 2, 2 minus 3 by 2, 3 minus 1 by 2. Which one is maximum in this case? 1 minus 2 by 2. Okay. 1 minus, this one is the biggest circle. So which one is tau maximum? Sigma 1 minus 2 by 2. If 2, 3 is the biggest circle, if 2, 3 is the biggest circle, then it will be sigma 2 minus 3 by 2. Do you understand this? Whenever you need to find tau maximum, always do this. This is a very interesting trick, my friend. Okay? Now, equal to SYT by 2FOS. 2 and 2 cancel. Now, put the values in the equation, my friend, and solve the equation. Put the values in this equation and solve the equation. So, what will be the equation, my friend? 10^6 divided by d cube. This is common. In this and this, 10^6 divided by d cube is common. Sigma 1 is 73.51 minus of sigma 2 equal to SYT by FOS. 2 and 2 is cancelled. So SYT was 350, FOS was 2. So this is the relation between the stresses and strength. What did I tell you in the first class? Remember the first class. In order to find the dimension of a machine element, what do you need? You need a relation between stresses and strength. Stresses and strength, and that is derived by using theory of failure. So from Guest theory, what is the relation between stresses and strength? Sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2 equals to SYT by 2 FOS. So if you put the values here, you will find the dimension of machine element. So now my friend, solve this equation and tell me what is the value of diameter. Tell me what is the value of diameter. So diameter value is 81.88 mm. The diameter, safe diameter, is 81.88 mm. So minimum diameter that you need to use is 81.88 mm from Guest theory, according to Guest theory. Now my friend, we have one more theory of failure. Which one? Von Mises theory. We have one more theory. Von Mises theory. Von Mises theory means which theory, my friend? I told you to remember the names. So Von Mises theory means which theory? Maximum distortion energy theory. Maximum distortion energy theory. Now sigma 3 is 0. So what will be the equation of maximum distortion energy theory? Remember the equation. Sigma 3 is 0. So what will be the equation? Sigma 1 square plus sigma 2 square minus sigma 1 into sigma 2 equal to SYT by FOS whole square. This is the relation, my friend, according to Von Mises theory. Now put the values of sigma 1 and sigma 2 in this relation, my friend. 10 to the power 6 and d cube. These are common things. So let me take that out of the equation. 10 to the power 6 divided by d cube whole square. Now sigma 1 square, it will be 73.51 square plus sigma 2 square. So it will become 22.58 square minus sigma 1 into sigma 2. Now sigma 2 is negative. So if you put negative, negative, negative will become positive. So you will get 73.51 into 22.58. Okay, this is equal to SYT by FOS whole square, right? This is equal to SYT by FOS whole square. Now my friend, solve this relation and you will get the value of diameter. Solve this equation according to Von Mises theory, you will get the diameter. Solve this relation. And find the diameter. Tell me what is the value of diameter. According to Von Mises. So it is 79.22 mm. If you have solved it on your own, congratulations, my friend. This is your first design. You have designed the first machine element of your life, a circular shaft, my friend. You have found out the diameter of the circular shaft. So congratulations on the successful design of your first machine element. So see, machine design is a very interesting concept, a very interesting subject, my friend, because you can relate this with the practical application. Okay, so if you need to design a circular shaft, then this is the process, my friend. You know the bending and twisting moment. This you can calculate using the equations of SOM. Okay, we have seen in the equation of SOM how we can calculate bending moment, how we can calculate twisting moment. This we have learned in SOM. Okay, now my friend, we need to find the diameter. So this is how we can find the diameter. We are getting two different diameter. Now my friend, remember yesterday I told you the comparison between maximum shear stress theory and Von Mises theory. What was the comparison, my friend? Remember the comparison of maximum shear stress theory, and maximum distortion energy theory. Remember the comparison? I told you maximum distortion energy theory is accurate. It is accurate. So accuracy in between MSST and MDET, which one is more accurate? MDET, maximum distortion energy theory. This is less accurate, this is more accurate, but the accuracy is not that different. this is less accurate, but it doesn't mean that the accuracy is very different. Okay, look at the values. Look at the values, my friend. 79.2 to 81.88. They are very close. Okay, but my friend, maximum shear stress theory is simpler. It is very simple to use and safer. It is also safer. Why, my friend? See, the equation of gas theory was very easy to solve, right? The equation was of gas theory was very easy to solve. So this was simpler. Plus, it is safer. Why it is safer? Look at this value, my friend. 81.88. It is greater than this. It is greater than this. So you are using a greater diameter. Means you are safer now. Okay, you are safer now. But remember, it does not mean that it is always good to be safer. See, more dimension means more conservative. Which theory is more conservative? This is more conservative, right? This is more conservative. Which theory is more conservative? Yesterday we discussed this. If you are getting more dimension, means it is more conservative. So it is not always good to be more conservative. Whether you have to be more conservative or less conservative, it depends upon a lot of things. Practically, whether you have to be more conservative or less conservative, it depends upon a lot of things. Sometimes we don't need to be conservative. Sometimes we need to be accurate. We don't need more value. We don't need to be safer. Okay, we need accurate value. So in that case, we use distortion energy theory. But in some cases, we need a simple theory and we need a safer theory. We need to be conservative. Then we will use shear stress theory. I will give you a very practical example. Okay, let's say you are designing a machine element which is going to be used in an aeroplane. Okay, you are designing a machine element which is going to be used in an aeroplane. Now in aeroplane, my friend, if any machine element will fail, it will be a huge risk. You don't want to take risk. So in that case, what is important for you? In that case, it is important for you to be safer. So you will be more conservative in that case. If you are designing an aeroplane, you will be more conservative. But my friend, if you are designing a machine, a element for a toy, okay, let's say you are designing a toy for babies, okay, kids. Now, my friend, if the toy fails, it will not be a huge risk. Okay, if the toy fails, then it will not be a loss of people, a loss of life. Okay, so in that case, you don't need to be conservative. You can be less conservative. Okay, less conservative means you can use distortion energy theory. If you are designing a toy, then you can use distortion energy theory, because my friend, in that case, there is no loss of life. Even if the machine element fails, it will not be a huge problem. So in that case, you can be less conservative. But if you are designing an aeroplane, then you have to be safer, my friend. So you will be more conservative. So in which case you will become more conservative, in which case we will become less conservative, that depends upon a lot of things. It also depends on environmental condition. If, my friend, environmental conditions are very harsh, let's say temperature is very high, there is corrosion, there is a humidity in air, so there will be corrosion. So environmental conditions are very harsh. So in that case, my friend, you will be safer. In that case, you will be more conservative. But let's say your machine element is subjected to room temperature. Let's say the conditions are normal. Then in that case, you can be less conservative. So it depends upon lot of things, my friend. Practically, it depends upon lot of things, whether you have to be more conservative or less conservative. More conservative means more dimension. More conservative means bigger dimension. Less conservative means smaller dimension. Do you understand this? So you don't have to be more conservative in every case. Don't think that we will be more conservative, we will be safer in every case, because you are wasting material. See, here the dimension is only this much. Here it is this much. So if you always use higher dimension, bigger dimension, you will always waste material. So you don't have to waste material in every case. Only in some cases, you have to invest in more material. You have to make bigger dimension. Do you understand that? All right, my friend. All right. So these are practical examples of the machine design, my friend. Practically, this is how an element is designed. Okay. Now, my friend, I will give you one more example. Okay. I have explained using a very important example how a machine element is designed, अंडर स्टैटिक लोडिंग. वी विल सी वन मोर एग्जाम्पल माई फ्रेंड, वन मोर एग्जाम्पल. ओके, हियर आई एम टेलिंग यू द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ फेलियर, हाउ थ्योरी ऑफ फेलियर इज अप्लाइड इन ऑर्डर टू डिजाइन मशीन एलिमेंट. ओके, सो वी सॉ वन वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर. वी विल सी अनदर एग्जाम्पल, वी विल सी वन मोर एग्जाम्पल माई फ्रेंड, वन मोर एग्जाम्पल. ओके, सो दिस एग्जाम्पल is related to design of pressure vessel, pressure vessel, okay, thin pressure vessel. So note this question down. A thin cylindrical pressure vessel, a thin cylindrical pressure vessel, a thin cylindrical pressure vessel of internal diameter 1 meter, of internal diameter 1 meter is subjected to internal pressure, is subjected to internal pressure, is subjected to internal pressure of 2 megapascal, of 2 megapascal, yield strength of the material is 300 megapascal, yield strength is 300 megapascal, factor of safety is 2.5, Poisson's ratio is 0.3, find safe thickness using first Hayes theory, using first Hayes theory and second St. Venant's theory. We need to use two different theories of failure for the design purpose, Hayes theory and St. Venant's theory, my friend. Here also we will solve this problem using two different theories of failure. Note this problem down. And then I will explain how pressure vessel can be designed using theories of failure. This is another practical example of application of theory of failure, my friend. So note this problem down. Note this problem down. All right. So now, my friend, let's find the thickness of the pressure vessel. It is a pressure vessel. Okay, what is pressure vessel? Vessel which is subjected to internal pressure. Okay, let's say you have a container. Let's say you have a container. Inside that container, high pressure fluid is stored. Okay, so that high pressure fluid is applying load on the pressure vessel. Okay, for example, LPG cylinder. LPG cylinder in your house. That is a pressure vessel because inside the cylinder there is high pressure fluid which is applying load on the cylinder. Now, my friend, if the thickness of the cylinder is less than the required value, what will happen, my friend? Cylinder will be blasted, my friend. Cylinder will blast. So you have to design the cylinder. You have to find a safe thickness of the cylinder so that there will be no failure. Otherwise, cylinder will fail. And it will blast, my friend. There will be loss of life. So you have to save people by finding a safe thickness, my friend. Okay. The lives of the people is in your hand, my friend. Being a good designer, you have to save people by finding a safe thickness for this cylinder, my friend. Okay. So let's find the safe thickness of this cylinder using two theories of failure. Hayes theory. Which one is Hayes theory? Tell me. Tell me which one is Hayes theory. I told you to remember the names. Okay. So you have to remember 5 names, my friend. Which one is Hayes theory, my friend? Maximum strain energy theory. Maximum strain energy theory. And which one is St. Venant's theory, my friend? Which one is St. Venant's theory? Maximum normal strain theory, right? So strain energy theory and normal strain theory. These two theories we have to use in order to find safe thickness, my friend. Two values you have to use this. Internal diameter 1 meter and the pressure 2 megapascal. Okay, these are the material property SYT and mu, and this is the factor of safety. Okay, so note these values down and then we will solve the problem and we will find the safe thickness, my friend. Okay, so we have a pressure vessel, thin cylindrical pressure vessel. Let's say this is the thin cylindrical pressure vessel. Okay, let's say this is a thin cylindrical pressure vessel. Let's say it is a hollow cylinder because you have to store the fluid, so it must be hollow. Now my friend, what is given? Diameter is given. Okay, diameter is given. The diameter is given, my friend. What is the diameter? 1 meter. Okay, and we need to find the thickness, my friend. We need to find this wall thickness. Okay, we need to find the wall thickness, my friend. Now my friend, you know that under internal pressure there are two stresses. Actually there are three stresses: longitudinal stress in x direction, there will be longitudinal stress sigma l; in y direction, there will be circumferential stress sigma c; and there is a third stress, let's say in z direction, sigma r, radial stress. But I told you, we don't consider radial stress in case of thin pressure vessel. In case of thick pressure vessel, radial stresses are large, so we consider them. But in case of thin pressure vessel, radial stresses are negligible, we don't consider them. So we only have two sigma, sigma l and sigma c. Okay, now my friend, these two stresses will be the principal stresses. Why these are principal stresses? What is principal plane? Plane at which tau is zero. On this plane tau is zero, on this plane tau is zero. Do you see any tau? If there is tau, it will look like this. It will look like this. So do you see any tau here and here? No tau. And if there is no tau, means this plane is principal plane, this plane is principal plane. Okay, if there is no tau, means this one is sigma 1, one of them is sigma 1, another one is sigma 2. If there is tau, then they will not be sigma 1 and 2, then they will not be sigma 1 and 2. But if there is no tau, then one of them will be sigma 1, one of them will be sigma 2. Do you understand this? We have seen this in principal stresses. Okay, all right my friend. So my friend, let's say sigma 1 is sigma c, circumferential stress. What is the equation of circumferential stress? In strength of material, we saw thin pressure vessel. What is the equation of sigma c? Pd by 2t, right? Pd by 2t. Put the values. What will you get, my friend? What is the pressure? 2 megapascal. Diameter is 1000 mm divided by 2t. What will you get, my friend? What will you get? 1000 divided by t. So this is the value of sigma 1. I told you, right now we don't know the dimension. So principal stresses will be in terms of dimension. In last problem, principal stress was in terms of diameter. In this problem, principal stress is in terms of thickness. We need to find the thickness. Sigma 2 will be sigma L, longitudinal stress. It will be Pd by 4t. Now my friend, if you are confused why this is sigma 1 and this is sigma 2, this can be sigma 1, this can be sigma 2, no problem, take that. It doesn't matter, my friend, which is 1 and which is 2. It doesn't matter. Okay, now my friend, put the values here. What will you get? What will you get, my friend? Put the values here. This is half of this, right? So it will be 500 by t. So this is sigma 1 and this is sigma 2 in terms of thickness. Now when we will put these values in theories of failure, we will get the value of thickness. So what is the first theory of failure, my friend? Hayes theory. We have to use Hayes theory. First we have to use Hayes theory, means maximum strain energy theory. Maximum strain energy theory. So what is the equation of strain energy theory? Sigma 3 is 0. Remember, sigma 3 is 0. Why? Because it is biaxial stress. Biaxial stress. Sigma 3 is 0, my friend. So put the values. What will be the relation, my friend? Sigma 1 square plus 2 square minus 2 mu. Sigma 1, sigma 2. Sigma 3 is 0. So this will become your relation. This is equal to SYT by FOS whole square. Put the value here and find out the thickness. Put the value here. Put the value here. 1/t is common. So let's take it common. 1/t². What is sigma 1? 1000. What is sigma 2? 500. What is mu? 0.3. What is SYT? What is SYT? 350. Right? 350 or 300? 300, sorry. SYT is 300 and factor of safety is 2.5. Factor of safety is 2.5. Okay? Now, my friend, this is the relation according to Hayes' theory. Find the value of thickness. Solve this relation. Find the value of thickness. What you will get, my friend? Solve this relation and find the value of thickness. Solve this equation in your calculator and find the value of thickness, my friend. Tell me what will you get? Tell me what will you get? Thickness should be equal to 8.12 mm. Thickness will be equal to 8.12 mm. This is according to Hayes' theory. Second theory of failure that we need to use is Saint Venant's theory, also known as maximum normal strain theory. So now, my friend, use maximum normal strain theory. What is the relation, my friend? Epsilon maximum is equal to SYT by EFOS. Now, how do we calculate epsilon maximum, my friend? I told you, epsilon maximum is maximum of epsilon 1, epsilon 2, and epsilon 3. What are epsilon 1, 2, 3? Principal strain. These are principal stress. These are principal strain. Now, my friend, which one is greater? Sigma 1, 2, or 3? Which one is greater? Sigma 1 is greater. If sigma 1 is greater, epsilon 1 will be greater. Right? If sigma 1 is greater, epsilon 1 will be greater. So, here it will be equal to epsilon 1. Okay? And which one? What will be the equation of epsilon 1, my friend? Sigma 3 is 0. There is sigma 1 and there is sigma 2. So, according to Hooke's law, it will be sigma 1 by E minus mu sigma 2 by E. Do you understand this, my friend? Epsilon maximum will be maximum of these three. Now, here sigma 1, 2, 3, out of these, which one is maximum? Sigma 1. So, here also epsilon 1 will be maximum. Now, my friend, epsilon 1 can be calculated using Hooke's law, this relation. Sigma 1 by E minus mu sigma 2 by E. Put the values here, my friend. E will be cancelled. What is SYT? 300. What is sigma 1? 1000 by T. Minus mu. What is sigma 2? 500 by T. So solve this relation and you will get the value of T. Solve this relation and you will get the value of 3. SYT by FOS. Sorry, here there will be factor of safety also. So SYT by FOS. Okay. Solve this relation and tell me what will be the thickness, my friend. Safe thickness. According to Saint Venant's theory, what is the safe thickness, my friend? It should be 7.08 mm. So according to Hayes' theory, how much thickness you need? 8.12. And according to Saint Venant, 7.08. Which one is more conservative? Between these two, which one is more conservative? This is more conservative. This is less conservative. Bigger dimension means more conservative. Smaller dimension means less conservative. Okay? So it is up to you. Which theory do you need to use? Okay. And although I've told you, in case of ductile material, which theory is suitable? 1 by stress theory or shear stress theory. For brittle material, which theory is suitable? Maximum normal stress theory. Okay. All right, my friend. All right. So these are practical examples, practical applications of theories of failure, my friend. Do you understand how a machine element is designed using theories of failure? What do we do? फर्स्ट वी फाइंड प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ डायमेंशन. देर इज वन अननोन डायमेंशन इन एवरी प्रॉब्लम, देर इज वन अननोन डायमेंशन. सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ दैट डायमेंशन वी गेट प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस, देन वी पुट द वैल्यूज ऑफ प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेसेस इन द इक्वेशंस ऑफ थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर. वी सॉल्व द इक्वेशन एंड वी गेट द डायमेंशन. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड द डिजाइन प्रोसेस? वेरी गुड माई फ्रेंड, हिट द लाइक बटन राइट नाउ इफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द प्रैक्टिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ फेलियर. हिट द लाइक बटन राइट नाउ माई फ्रेंड, शो योर अप्रिसिएशन एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू यूज दिस वीडियो विद ऑल योर फ्रेंड. आई टोल्ड यू, यू हैव टू सपोर्ट अस माई फ्रेंड. दिस इज योर यूट्यूब चैनल, वी ऑल आर अ फैमिली ऑफ 52,000 पीपल माई फ्रेंड. ओके, 52,000 सब्सक्राइबर्स मीन्स 52,000 स्टूडेंट्स, 52,000 पीपल इन अ फैमिली. सो वी आर अ ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल, वी आर मेंबर्स ऑफ फैमिली, वी हैव टू सपोर्ट ईच अदर. सो वी आर सपोर्टिंग यू बाय प्रोवाइडिंग अमेजिंग कंटेंट, अमेजिंग वीडियोज, बाय गिविंग यू लेक्चर नोट्स, पीडीएफ्स ऑफ ई बुक्स. एंड यू कैन सपोर्ट अस बाय प्रमोटिंग आवर चैनल, बाय शोइंग दिस चैनल, शोइंग दीज वीडियोज टू ऑल योर फ्रेंड्स माई फ्रेंड. ओके, ऑल राइट माई फ्रेंड. सो दिस वॉज द प्रैक्टिकल यूज ऑफ थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर. दिस इज हाउ मशीन एलिमेंट्स आर डिजाइन. नाउ माई फ्रेंड, देर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू थ्योरीज ऑफ फेलियर, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट, बिकॉज दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज आस्क्ड इन एवरी एग्जाम. इन एवरी एग्जाम यू विल सी प्रॉब्लम्स, क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन दिस कॉन्सेप्ट माई फ्रेंड. ओके, सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट that you have to understand and that you have to note down. Okay, so my friend, what is this concept? This concept is estimated shear strength. Estimated shear strength. Now first of all, let me explain what is shear strength. What is strength, my friend? First of all, understand the meaning of strength, because we have been using this word for a lot of time. So what is the meaning of strength? Strength means how much stress you can apply on material. Let's say we have mild steel and I can apply 300 megapascal on mild steel. After 300 megapascal, mild steel fails. So what is the strength of mild steel? 300 megapascal, because maximum you can apply 300, after that mild steel fails. So strength of mild steel is 300. So strength means maximum stress that you can apply without failure. Failure should not happen. Without failure, maximum stress how much you can apply. Now shear strength means how much maximum shear stress you can apply. See, till now we have been using this SYT, right? In every problem, in every example, I always give you SYT. What is SYT? Yield strength. S stands for strength. Y stands for yielding. T stands for tension. So SYT is tensile strength. How much tensile stress you can apply? How much tensile stress you can apply? If you are applying compressive stress, then my friend, what will be the strength? It will be SYC. So SYT is tensile strength, SYC is compressive strength. Now my friend, SYT and SYC for ductile material, SYT and SYC are almost equal. If you know SYT, SYC will always be almost equal. Okay. Now, my friend, minimum strength of ductile material is in shear. Shear strength is very less. What will be shear strength, my friend? If you are applying tensile load, tensile strength. If you are applying compressive load, compressive strength. So here I will apply shear. Here I will apply shear. So here it will be SYS. How much shear stress you can apply? Okay, let's say you are applying shear stress. After a point, it will fail. So at what shear stress it will fail? That will be its shear strength. SYS is shear strength. SYT, tensile strength. SYC, compressive strength. SYS, shear strength. And for ductile material, which one is least? shear strength is max, least, shear stress is minimum, and the tile material fail in shear, my friend. The tile material fail in shear. Now let's assume you know SYT. Let's assume you know SYT and you need SYS. Let's assume you know SYT and you need SYS. So in this topic, we will find estimated value, approximate value of SYS. Okay, let's say you know the value of SYT, but you don't know the value of SYS. You know tensile strength, you don't know shear strength. So how will you find shear strength? That we have to see in this topic. Do you understand what we have to do in this topic? We know SYT. Let's say we know SYT, but we don't know SYS. So in this topic, we will find SYS, estimated shear strength. And how will we find? Using theories of failure. How will we find the value of SYS? Using theories of failure, my friend. Okay. Now, my friend, in every problem related to theories of failure, what is the first process? What is the first step? We just discussed this. What is the first step in any problem related to theories of failure? Whenever you have to apply theory of failure, what do you need first? You need principal stresses. You need principal stresses. Now, my friend, here there is only shear stress. And in case of shear stress, only shear stress, this is known as pure shear. So in case of pure shear, what is the Mohr circle? I told you many times. What is the Mohr circle? I told you many times. What is the Mohr circle? On this plane, what is the value? SYS. What is sigma? Zero. What is tau? SYS. On this plane, what is the value? Sigma again zero, but tau minus SYS. Here it is SYS, so here it is minus SYS. So these are the two points. Join these points and draw a circle. So this is the Mohr circle of pure shear. This is the Mohr circle of pure shear. Center will be at 0, 0. In case of pure shear, center of Mohr circle will be at 0, 0, right? Now, my friend, this is the first principal stress. This is the second principal stress. What will be the first principal stress, my friend? In case of pure shear, what will be the first principal stress? Tau, whatever tau. So what is the tau? SYS. Maximum tau. This is maximum tau, SYS. What will be sigma 2? Minus SYS. This is plus SYS. This is minus SYS. This is the Mohr circle of pure shear. On this plane, what is sigma? 0. What is tau? SYS. On this plane, what is sigma? 0. What is tau? Minus SYS. Sorry. 0 and plus SYS, 0 and minus SYS. Then we draw diameter and then we draw circle. Now this is your first principal plane. This is your second principal plane. On first principal plane, what is sigma? Plus SYS. On second principal plane, what is sigma? Minus SYS. Okay, so this is the Mohr circle. Okay, I will explain it one more time. I will explain it one more time. So on this plane, what is sigma? 0. What is tau? Plus SYS. It will be somewhere here. On this plane, what is sigma? 0. What is tau? Minus SYS. So it will be somewhere here. Join these two points. You will get diameter of Mohr circle. And then you can draw Mohr circle. So this is Mohr circle, center will be at the origin. This is first principal plane, this is second principal plane, SYS minus SYS. Do you understand this much? What will be sigma 3? 0. Okay. Now, my friend, we need to calculate SYS. We will use theories of failure. So what is the first theory of failure? First theory, maximum normal stress theory. Maximum normal stress theory. What is the relation of maximum normal stress theory? Sigma maximum equal to SYT by FOS. Now here, my friend, I need how much maximum value of stress I can apply. I need the stress at which failure will occur. I need the value of stress at which failure will occur. So I will take factor of safety equal to 1. Factor of safety is used to keep the stresses less than the maximum. To keep the stresses less than maximum. But here I need to calculate how much maximum I can go. So factor of safety will be 1. Now my friend, what is sigma maximum? Tell me what is sigma maximum. Sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. What is sigma maximum? SYS. Right. Sigma maximum will be SYS. So according to maximum normal stress theory, what is shear stress? What is shear strength? According to maximum normal stress theory, shear strength is equal to tensile strength. Okay, shear strength is equal to tensile strength. According to which theory? Maximum normal stress theory. Now, in this way, you can find this relation using every theory of failure, my friend. Okay, so do it on your own. I want you to do this on your own, my friend. I have explained one theory. Use all the other theory and find a relation between SYS and SYT. For example, what is the second theory, my friend? Maximum shear stress theory. Maximum shear stress theory. What is the relation, my friend? Maximum shear stress theory. Apply maximum shear stress theory and tell me what will be the relation, my friend. Tau maximum equal to SYT by 2FOS. And here I am taking FOS equal to 1 because I am calculating the maximum stress. Okay. Now, tau maximum, which one will be tau maximum, my friend? What is the tau maximum? What is the radius? SYS. Radius is SYS. So, SYS will be equal to 0.5 SYT. This is the relation between shear strength and tensile strength according to maximum shear stress theory. What is the relation, my friend? Tell me what is the relation. Shear strength is half of tensile strength. According to this, shear strength is equal to tensile strength. According to this, shear strength is half of tensile strength. In this way, you can find other relations also. Okay, let's use maximum strain energy theory. Let's use maximum strain energy theory. So what is the equation, my friend? Sigma 1 square plus 2 square minus 2 mu sigma 1 sigma 2 equal to SYT by FOS whole square, but FOS is 1. Now my friend, here you need some value of mu. So what I will do, I will use a common value of mu. Common value for metals. For metals, usually mu is around 0.3. So I will use 0.3. So put the values here. SYS square plus SY square. As sigma 2 is negative, so negative and negative will become positive. 2 into 0.3. This will also become SYS square equals to SYT square. So here what you will get, my friend? SYS equals to, according to strain energy theory, my friend, SYS. How much will you get? Calculate it. SYS according to strain energy theory. Tell me the value of SYS according to strain energy theory, my friend. Tell me the value. SYS will be equal to 0.62 SYT. 0.62 SYT. Okay, so this is the third relation according to strain energy theory. Fourth one. Maximum distortion energy theory. What is the relation, my friend? Sigma 1 square plus 2 square minus sigma 1 sigma 2 equal to SYT square, right? Put the values here. So what you will get? SYS square plus SYS square minus, this will also become SYS square equal to SYT square. So from here, my friend, what will you get? SYS equal to 0.577 times of SYT. Put the values and solve it. You will get this. SYS equal to 0.577 times of SYT, my friend. This is the fourth relation between shear strength and tensile strength. The fifth one, my friend. What is the fifth equation, fifth theory of failure? Maximum normal strain theory. Maximum normal strain theory. Okay. Now, my friend, fifth theory. एप्सिलॉन मैक्सिमम इक्वल टू एस वाई टी बाय ई एफओ एस, अगेन एफओ एस इज वन. नाउ विच वन विल बी मैक्सिमम माई फ्रेंड, सिग्मा वन और सिग्मा टू? वन इज पॉजिटिव, वन इज नेगेटिव, डजेंट मैटर, यू कैन कंसिडर एनी वन. सो लेट से सिग्मा वन, सो एप्सिलॉन वन विल ऑल्सो बी मैक्सिमम, एप्सिलॉन वन विल ऑल्सो बी मैक्सिमम. एंड वॉट विल बी एप्सिलॉन वन माई फ्रेंड? सिग्मा वन बाय ई माइनस म्यू सिग्मा टू बाय, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू एस वाई टी बाई ई ई ई कैंसल, सिग्मा थ्री इज जीरो. ओके, नाउ पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्मा वन एस वाई एस माइनस पॉइंट थ्री, सिग्मा टू इज नेगेटिव, सो नेगेटिव नेगेटिव पॉजिटिव, एस वाई एस इक्वल टू एस वाई टी. सो कैलकुलेट वॉट विल बी द रिलेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू नॉर्मल स्ट्रेन थ्योरी. टेल मी माई फ्रेंड, टेल मी द फिफ्थ रिलेशन. सो वन पॉइंट वन अपॉन 1.3, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू 0.77 एस पाई टी. दिस इज द थर्ड रिलेशन माई फ्रेंड, दिस इज द थर्ड रिलेशन, सॉरी फिफ्थ रिलेशन, दिस इज द फिफ्थ रिलेशन. एस वाई एस इक्वल्स टू 0.77 टाइम्स ऑफ एस वाई टी. सो वी हैव दीज फाइव रिलेशन बिटवीन एस वाई एस शियर स्ट्रेंथ, एस वाई टी टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ. नाउ माई फ्रेंड, प्रैक्टिकली वी नो विच वन विल बी एक्यूरेट. सो प्रैक्टिकली विच रिलेशन इज मोर एक्यूरेट? प्रैक्टिकली माई फ्रेंड, दिस रिलेशन इज मोर एक्यूरेट. दिस इज वॉट वन माइसेस थ्योरी. सो फॉर डक्टाइल मटीरियल विच थ्योरी इज मोर एक्यूरेट? वन माइसेस थ्योरी. सो प्रैक्टिकली दिस रिलेशन इज मोर एक्यूरेट बिकॉज वी नो वॉट इज द शियर स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ अ मटीरियल. सो वी नो विच वन विल बी क्लोजर टू द एक्चुअल वैल्यू. दिस इज क्लोजर टू द एक्चुअल वैल्यू. ओके, सो मोर एक्यूरेट वैल्यू इज विच वन? मोर एक्यूरेट रिलेशन, मोर एक्यूरेट रिलेशन इज एस वाई एस इक्वल्स टू 0.577 टाइम्स एस वाई टी. बट माई फ्रेंड, समटाइम्स यू डोंट नीड टू बी एक्यूरेट, समटाइम्स यू नीड टू बी कंजर्वेटिव. आई टोल्ड यू वॉट इज कंजर्वेटिव, मोर डायमेंशन, बिगर डायमेंशन. ओके, सो मोर कंजर्वेटिव रिलेशन विल बी विच वन? विच वन इज मोर कंजर्वेटिव माई फ्रेंड? 0.5 टाइम्स ऑफ एस वाई टी, दिस वन इज मोर कंजर्वेटिव. ओके, सो दिस वन इज एक्यूरेट, दिस वन इज एक्यूरेट, बट इन सम केसेस वी यूज दिस वन. वाई? बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट टू बी कंजर्वेटिव. ओके, वी वॉन्ट टू बी सेफर, वी वॉन्ट टू बी सेफर. सो टू बी सेफर साइड, टू बी ऑन सेफर साइड, टू बी कंजर्वेटिव, वी यूज दिस रिलेशन. ओके, नाउ माई फ्रेंड, यू विल गेट थ्योरी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक. यू विल गेट थ्योरी क्वेश्चन. इन मोस्ट केसेस दे विल आस्क यू वॉट इज शियर स्ट्रेंथ, वॉट इज शियर स्ट्रेंथ अकॉर्डिंग टू ईदर शियर स्ट्रेस थ्योरी और वन माइसेस थ्योरी. ओके, इन मोस्ट केसेस दे विल ओनली आस्क यू शियर स्ट्रेस थ्योरी एंड वन माइसेस थ्योरी. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू शियर स्ट्रेस थ्योरी, वॉट इज द शियर स्ट्रेंथ? 0.5 टाइम्स ऑफ एस वाई टी. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू वन माइसेस थ्योरी, वॉट इज द शियर स्ट्रेंथ? 0.577 टाइम्स ऑफ एस वाई टी. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस? डू यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस? यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दीज टू, you have to remember these two. You will find a lot of one mark question from this relation. So remember these two relation my friend. Okay, remember these two relation, very important relation. Remember at least these two. Even if you don't remember these three, don't worry, but you have to remember these two relation at least my friend. I guarantee you, you will find a lot of one mark question based on this relation my friend. Okay, so please remember these relations. Okay, please remember these relation. Okay my friend, now I will solve a numerical based on this relation. Okay, I will solve a numerical based on this relation my friend, and this numerical is from gate my friend. Okay, this numerical is from gate my friend, this numerical is from gate. So let's solve a numerical based on this relation. Okay, let's solve a numerical based on this relation. My friends, please join the Telegram channel because I will give the PDF of previous year question on our Telegram channel. I have already given the PDF of previous year solved problems of strength of material. Okay, strength of material solved problems of gate. Okay, so if you want the PDF of machine design also, please join our telegram channel, join our telegram channel, okay, join our telegram channel. We will be posting a lot of study material on our telegram channel, and we will only give the study material on telegram channel, okay. We can't give it on the YouTube, okay. So we can only send the PDF of our lectures, PDF of the study material on our telegram channel. So don't forget to join our telegram channel and also our Facebook group. We also have a Facebook group. The link is given in the description. So please join those channels, my friend. Okay. So let's solve this problem, my friend. Let's say we have the state of stress of a material at the time of yielding. At the time of yielding, these are the stresses. Okay. Understand the problem. At the time of yielding, these are the stresses acting on the material. These are the stresses acting on the material, all in megapascal. Okay, at the time of yielding, at the time of yielding, these are the stresses. Okay, this is known as what? Tensor. Okay, instead of diagram, we can show the stresses in terms of matrix. So this is a tensor matrix. So this is the matrix of stresses at the time of yielding. Now, my friend, we need to find shear stress in yield according to von Mises theory. What do we need to find? Shear stress in yield. At the time of yielding, these are different stresses. What do we need to find? Shear stress in yield, my friend. Okay. Now, how do we find shear stress in yield? In order to find shear stress in yield, we will use the relation. What is the relation, my friend? Sigma ys. Shear stress in yield is equal to 0.577 sigma yt. Okay. So tensile stress, if you know the tensile stress, you can calculate the shear stress. Okay. 0.577 times. So we will use this relation, my friend, but before using this relation, we need sigma yt, and to calculate sigma yt using von Mises theory, we need principal stresses. So first step in this problem is to find principal stresses. Okay. First step is to find principal stresses. Then using principal stresses, we will find sigma yt. And then using sigma yt, we will find sigma ys, my friend. Okay. So let's first find the principal stresses. Okay. Now, how will we find the principal stress in this case? I solved this problem, my friend. I told you how to solve this type of problem. Triaxial stress. The rows of matrix are the plane. So the first row is yz plane. Second row is xz plane. Third row is xy plane. Now in this row, what are the value of shear stress? Tell me the value of shear stress. Compare this matrix using this matrix. Sigma x, tau xy, tau xz, tau yx, sigma y, tau yz, tau zx, tau zy, sigma z. Okay. So compare this matrix. What is tau zx? Zero. What is tau zy? Zero. You only have sigma z. So if tau zx as zy are zero and there is only sigma, what is this plane, my friend? What is this plane? The plane at which there is no tau. What is this plane? Principal plane. This is a principal plane. If there is no tau, if there is only sigma, then it is called as principal plane. These two will also be zero zero because it needs to be symmetric. Okay. So there is no tau, there is only sigma, principal plane. These two are not principal plane. Why? Because there is one tau here. On this plane, on the first plane, there is one tau. On the second plane, there is one tau. But on the third plane, both the tau are zero. Look at this. On third plane, both the tau are zero. So this is a principal plane. This is a principal plane. Okay. And if it is a principal plane, then this sigma will be a principal stress. So sigma 3 is minus 10. Do you understand this much? Now we have to calculate sigma 1 and sigma 2. So what we will do? You have sigma x, you have sigma y, you have tau xy. So you can directly use this formula. Sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus minus root over sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau xy square. So do you know this formula? Do you remember this formula? Direct formula for sigma 1 and sigma